If you like our videos, consider checking out our Patreon. Hey everybody, Gutter here, and I'm here with Season 4 Retrospective Part 2. And if you remember from last time, the Promo Soup cast is in descent. Like I was saying to Bernie the other day, it's like, we never had a peak. We're in Season 4. It took us, you know, up to this point to even get watchable, and by this point we're already starting to lose people. But anyway, let's just get into the disclaimer and some of Ashley, mine and Bird's favorite intros we did for Promo Soup. It's fucking goofy as hell. It's conservative me and Bird being attacked by the evil Gutter and Bird. Check this out.
Warning. If you want to see a show of glamorous people that have traditional, wholesome values, who care how anyone perceives their words and actions, well, guess what? You better change the channel right now. Because the corporate guinea pigs are not those people and never will be. So be prepared for coarse language, notoriously obese man, and the anarchy-based style of Primal Soup. So if you're bored enough to watch this show, don't be stupid enough to try any of it at home.
George Bush. I do. I love him.
Yes. I find him quite honest and forthcoming.
Charles, who is that at the door?
I don't know. I will go find out.
Every time we read, someone disturbs us.
Love it. But anyway, moving on from that, we're moving on to an intro for an episode of Promo Soup. And like I said, the cast was dwindling at this point. I don't even know why. It was ended up just being me and Boo introing this episode. But anyway, check this out.
Hey guys, we're back. New episode of Primal Soup with a very, very extra special edition of Primal Soup.
Special? What do you mean special? Like short bus special?
Oh, more like we all had better stuff to do than actually come up with an episode this week.
Yeah, that's right. That's basically it, yeah.
So, we're taking a trip with Casey and Leanne.
Yeah, they went to Las Vegas, Nevada to see Leanne's mom get married. And after that, they drove 2,500 miles back.
Now, see, it doesn't sound like too big of a task, but you gotta understand...
2,300 miles is a hell of a task.
But you gotta understand riding with Casey. That's taking your life into your hands. Especially 2,300 miles worth.
Anyway, her husband Larry had to drive his bike the whole way back from Vegas and through snow and rain and all that crap. But anyway, on this episode you also see three great artist showcases.
Really good.
Yep. But anyway, check all that out. We'll come back in the middle of the episode to
say what's up. Check in on you guys.
Yeah, make sure you're still there. Anyway, go to the new website coming soon. Hopefully. whatisproblemsoup.com. But anyway, check us out. We'll be back.
But hey, at least we had the footage that Casey and Leanne brought back from their Vegas trip and stuff. And a little side note, a little behind-the-scenes information. During that trip, my niece Lana was conceived. I thought you... Not on my niece Lana, just that Casey and Leanne... But I thought you could have used a little throw-up in the back of your mouth. But anyway, moving on from that, we're moving on to tractor racing. Boo, back in the day, used to tractor race. So, of course, you know, one of our friends did something and stuff, and it was fucking goofy as fucking hell, so we said, fuck it, let's go film tractor racing. And this is another one of those clips that I ended up recutting years after Primal Soup was over and changing the music and all, making it one clip, because it was throughout a fucking episode, like a lot of these clips are. But anyway, tractor racing.
Hey, Casey, what's up, man?
After 3 weeks of anticipation, Chuck, we finally get to do it. I can't believe it.
3 weeks, and it's finally here.
Yeah, we're going to the Food Stamp 500. What's the Food Stamp 500, Chuck?
Well, check this out right here. You'll see. Well, anyway, that's what the Food Stamp 500 is. Lawn tractor racing at Blanket Hill Speedway.
Right off of 422.
Yep, so we're going to... check out some lawn tractor racing right now.
Oh, and one of our racers is in it, Boo.
One of our racers is in it?
One of our racers. Well,
one of the guinea pigs is in the race, Boo.
Oh, okay.
So
one of the racers is a corporate guinea pig.
Yes. So anyway, check out this race and we'll be back after this.
All right, guys. Hey, what's going on? This is Boo. We're up here at Blanket Hill Raceway. Gonna do some tractor racing. Now, this is my first time, so don't expect too much. We're gonna go throughout the track, check out, see what's going on, talk to some people. Right here in this little area, this is what I like to call the corporate guinea pig family of drivers, because basically I'm a corporate guinea pig and they're my family. So right here we got my cousin Michael's tractor. This is number 10, the Sin Wagon. Looks pretty, don't it? It's gonna look real pretty when I'm passing. And over here, come on. This is my sweet ride. This one we named Star Graven Matt. Got a couple laps in. It's gonna be fun, real fun.
Give me back my whiskey, motherfucker. Give me back my booze, I'll tell you why. You make me come and get it, you will soon sorely regret it. Give me back my whiskey, motherfucker. Give me back my money, motherfucker. Give me back my hard-earned spending cash.
Well, got up in that loose shit up there. Couldn't really do nothing about it. Backed off, but I was already spinning, so. Yeah, it's better than flipping it over like Uncle Ed, so. We'll get here a couple weeks. We'll be back out here trying again. So, Catch y'all later.
Yeah, Boo did fucking awful that day. Fucking awful. But moving on from that, we're moving on to the first segment of the footage from Casey and Leanne's trip to Vegas. You know, just a whole bunch of random Vegas stuff with some music underneath, you know. Check it out, Vegas random stuff. So you thought you might be a conservative, jokes were done last retrospective? Yeah, so did I. I guess they're not. You might be a conservative.
If you hate whoever it's in fashion to hate at any particular time, whether it's Native American peoples, or Eskimos, or Haitians, or Aborigines, or black people, or women, or gays, or... well, just about anybody you can think of who we hate next, we might be a conservative.
So for the season finale that season, we decided we were going to build a wigwam up at Ray's. Why? I don't fucking remember. We just needed something to film. I think throughout these segments, I even say something about not having ideas and nobody being around to film, but whatever. The beginning of us building a wigwam.
What are you doing here anyway? Well, we're going to build a wigwam, actually, is what we're going to do. And we've made a 14-foot circle here. And we're gonna take these saplings that I've cut. They're about 15 feet long. And we're gonna bend them into a hut shape and tie them together.
Okay, I won't even ask why or anything. Make us walk up a big hill and tie sticks together.
Don't ask why.
Don't worry, Ray, I'm just messing with you. Yeah, Bird, I don't know, Bird. What happens if that kicks out?
Uh-huh.
Tool!
That takes
Bird. Good call, Sydney. Well, Bird, you know, if that would have happened, you wouldn't have been able to have any more kids.
Drive, pull your
all right, hit me in the balls again.
I foresee blood here. Where'd Ray go? He's up in the trees like a Three Stooges episode.
Hey, now, I remember. Must have been in another life, but I remember making these.
Ray, you're like
in
our
this
man.
Very spot.
Yeah, you have the conveniences of like nylon twine or.
Traditionally, we did this with basswood strips, actually, to be precise. But since we have no basswood, we're using these are hickory. Yeah. And this is an elm tree, actually. And we have some ash also.
So yeah, as the cast was starting to fucking dwindle, our friend Ty Stick ended up starting getting involved, and he stayed involved from this point on for quite some fucking time. But, you know, during this time also, we decided, oh fuck, we need something, let's do a chase scene, just where somebody or something is chasing somebody else with, you know, like a music video kind of fucking thing. Here's, which I think is pretty much, besides way back in the day, the first Primal Soup chase scene. I guess that was kind of influenced by Evil Dead. I don't fucking remember. But anyway, moving on from that, we're moving on to another conservative joke. Holy fuck, how many of these fucking were there?
If you believe in politics of fear, even if you call yourself a democratic nation, you might be a conservative.
So it's been a little bit, so let's check in with Casey and Leanne and see how their trip's going.
Hi, this is Leanne from Primal Soup, and we're at the Hoover...
Darn!
And one interesting fact about this Hoover...
Darn!
Is no water goes over it. It goes around it through these turbines. And that's how the energy is collected. Take a look.
And moving on to another segment that I thought was over, but it's fucking not. Jovision.
Are you stupid idiot or what?
Yeah, I'm standing right by the tunnel, and this is his sheer face on the opposite side of the road. Again, the waterfall. Give you an idea. Just unbelievable how they were able to build this highway out of cutting the rock, dynamiting to build this highway. This burned out section was the part of the park that was on fire last year. We first started talking about coming here. A girl Sandy worked for came in one day and said to Dar, well, you realize the park's on fire, and it swept up this valley and actually went up over the hill. And the forest ranger said that it was tragic, but on the other hand, now all kind of wildfires are blooming in there. The pine cones that are really tight have opened up, dropped their seeds, and they're getting seedlings, and in 5, 10, 15 years the forest will be back the way it was.
We're on the western side, so I'm going to the Sun Highway. Wanted to get a picture of this valley going in here. This nice waterfall.
So now it's about time we check in and see how the progress on the wigwam's doing.
Here's my tall man. Come hold it.
Imperial Tyler goes flying all up in the air. You make the dude that weighs 90 pounds hold the thing, it's gonna fling him up in the air.
Oh, what's snapping, man?
Okay. All right.
Did I say that I'd foresee blood?
Let me show you how we do this.
We go to the emergency room.
We bend them. We pre-bend. Like we did in old country.
Italy?
Yugoslavia?
Yeah.
Siberia?
Mississippi? I don't know what it is.
We're just awful with jokes today.
Yeah.
Jokes and jokes and jokes and jokes.
I told you.
And then right, we break it. Throw them away.
They're cheap. We should use them as
hold on.
Lightsabers. We beat each other.
We'll use this one.
Dun, dun, dun.
Ray's like Armani for MTV.
Armani?
Armani.
Who's Armani?
Armani. Who's Armani? The dude Manny from Wild Boys.
Oh.
He's ours.
Travis holding this up while he's waiting.
Travis?
Travis? Travis? Hey, don't mess with Travis, man.
Oh my God.
So moving on from that, we're moving on to another PSN. And the PSNs are at this point, we're kind of starting to fall a little bit because there was less of them. And, you know, we didn't have many people to work with. So another one was just Ken Onassis and Boo playing another character.
Hi, I'm Ken Onassis. You're watching PSN Primal Soup. Once again, I'm back. Live in the studios. And today we're going to talk to Surly Sal, the Cynical Sports Reporter. He's going to be ranting and raving about some crazy shit. And I'm going to meet him up with Mexican Midget. He's back once again. And I am currently on some crazy drugs that I'm not sure what they're called. But hey, these things happen. Alright, now I'm going to take you to Surly Sal, the Cynical Sports Reporter. If I have to say that again, I'm going to cut my f***ing head off. Thanks. Go ahead there, Sal.
Thanks, Ken. I hope that rash you got never heals up. How'd you get the anchorman position anyway? Your way to the top, I bet. That's not what I come to talk about. I came to talk about it's springtime. And there's two things I hate going on right now. First is spring training. A bunch of people from the Philippines getting paid millions of dollars to come up and use steroids and hit a ball. Talk about boring. I'd rather watch two little old ladies play frickin' foosball for 9 hours than that god baseball. And another thing, March Madness. Now who the cares about college basketball? A bunch of punks out there taking away money from kids who need schooling, out there to either go out and make millions of dollars, not even use the god education, go back and work in the god Walmart where they should be. Now, god. Now we gotta go back to Ken, you son of a.
Thanks, Sal. Appreciate all that crazy, crap you just spewed on us and the audience. I'm sure they appreciate it immensely. Now I'm going to take you live to the Mexican Midget where he's going to rant about something. It's Mexican Midget. You never know what to expect. Go ahead, Midget. Take it away.
Hey, thanks, Ken. It's me, Random Jarvato Reporter, reporting live here in the Vatican, home somewhere out there in Rome. I don't know. Hey, I just wanted to talk about that Pope dude. Hey, did you see him recently there, Holmes? I mean, he was all slumped over in his chair and everything. I mean, how the hell is this guy gonna run the church when he can't even run to the toilet to take a poop, Holmes? I don't know what that's all about. But I can tell you one thing. That some of these, nuns out here, they looking some pretty hot up in those pieces. I was about to bend one of them over.
Thanks, Midget. Pretty crazy stuff, if I say so myself. Anyway, anybody who's interested in getting a hold of PSN, me, myself, or Mexican Midget, or Surly Sal, the Cynical Psycho, or that's it. If you want to get a hold of us, go to the whatisprimalsoup.com. We're going to promote that every day. I'm Ken Onassis, reporting live from PSN Primal Soup News.
While in Vegas, Casey and Leanne ran into a really cool fucking street artist that, you know, did pretty cool art with spray paint and stuff. So they filmed him, and they talked to him, and they ended up doing a Primal Soup's artist showcase, Tony Vegas.
shining bright. Looks so cool, temperature is zero. Now I drive real fast cause I got the ride. El Camino.
El Camino.
Show some crack.
Holy force! Man!
He made it.
I have no idea, dude.
That was a good job, Case.
We're gonna use him for house break-ins.
Oh my god.
Liposuction, you need.
That was like folding myself in half. I'm too fat for that.
So moving on from that, we're gonna check back in and see how the progress is going with the wigwam again.
Oh boy.
Ray, you want me to hold you?
Ooh, bird.
Bird, what's your
I didn't mean that.
We're there. Now I need that strength.
Thank you, sir.
This is gonna be a pretty cool one.
Okay. Whoa! Oh.
He just gave us a moment of stupidity.
Hey, the Indians did that. You don't think the Indians fell off their ladder? You're fooling.
Ladders?
Indians stacked their children on top of each other.
I was going to say, the big Indian got on the bottom and the little Indian stood on top of them.
Yeah.
Is it Frankie that I'm right behind?
Dad's from the little Indian tribe.
Does it
now? Yeah, Mike.
Ow!
Yeah, Mike. So, what are you doing after all this?
You are not the Jedi.
Too bad we can't get some bark.
We might be able to get bark. If not, that's okay because after the white man came here, we learned to use tarps.
Yeah, and we're after the white man.
Of course, they sold us canvas tarps, which suck like wood, but we probably...
What do we use? Big blue plastic tarps?
Yeah, because that's the way the Native Americans did it.
That's the way we'll do it.
So moving on from that, we're moving on to what I would have to say is my all-time favorite propaganda man. I don't know why I like it. I like Boo's costume in it. I kind of like the beginning thing. Well, fuck it. I like the whole fucking thing. Propaganda man, whatever number this would be.
Warning. You are about to see a social commentary by the corporate guinea pigs. Just remember, we have the right to voice our opinion openly and freely. Just like you. We, the corporate guinea pigs, are true patriots exercising our Constitution-given rights. So, in short, kiss my...
From that, we're going to check back in with Casey and Leanne's trip. But this time, they're all on their way home, driving back across America. So let's check out this.
Larry's going to take his bike 2,300 miles back to Pennsylvania. He's going to be our leader. We're going to follow him in the Jeep. Look at that beautiful bike.
Back to say our adios and farewell to Las Vegas, Nevada. We're beginning our trip back home to Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, covering 2,300 miles. And our first pit stop will be Williams, Arizona, where we're going to tour the Grand Canyon. So we'll see you there.
Out here is just spectacular. I can see for miles and miles and miles. It's unreal. We haven't left Nevada yet, but we're on our way. I can't wait to see what Arizona looks like. I heard Texas is nothing but crap, but I'm interested in seeing some Arizona countryside.
We made it to our first pit stop on our way back home to Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Right now we're at the Grand Canyon. Spectacular. Very cold, but beautiful. So take a look.
Check this out, guys.
Cause if we miss a show tonight, you know there's gonna be fights. They're gonna get it
overnight. We had lovely snow and ice, cool down here. And we're heading to New Mexico, which is about 500 miles away. So we're continuing our 2,300 mile journey to Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Heading to Tulsa, Oklahoma, which is about 400 miles away, and that'll be our final destination for today. And the weather's cloudy, cold, we hit rain, snow, and sleet coming down here. So we're hoping for some warm weather as we carry on, and catch you later. Peace. We came out of this shop, and it stinks out here. Texas smells like manure.
And this is the beginning of us starting to use Cottonmouth Kings, because I swear to fucking God, we had permission to use Suburban Noise Records music. Hell, I had a big-ass box of CDs sent to me by Kevin Zinger him fucking self. Well, we'll get more into that next season, because we talk about it more, and there's more Cottonmouth Kings stuff in the next season. But anyway, let's just move straight into Ray's artist showcase, because if you remember a couple retrospectives ago, like I said, Casey's parents are both professional photographers. So anyway, here's Ray's artist showcase.
Hi, I'm Casey's dad. I'm Ray Skiles. I take some 35 millimeters for the Primal Soup gang, and these are some black and whites that I took when I was in school. Thought you might like them. Call it the Elephant Eye Collection. I never can remember anything, but I can remember almost everywhere I was and everything I did when I was at one of these shoots and took one of these shots.
Why the fuck was he wearing that hat and that wig in the beginning? Fuck if I know. I don't fucking remember. I don't fucking know. But anyway, moving on from that, we're going to check back in on the progress of the wigwam.
That's how organized we are. Well, actually, you know, they called it disorganized organization. They had everything there, but I'm not sure where it was.
I might need a bigger person up there with you.
Come on, Sandy, go, come on, man. Any more Indian women could do this. There you go.
What's your
idea? Now you're talking. Now you're talking. All right. Now we need to get some bend on that case. We need an arch, you know. Okay. Right there. How's that look? What do you think, gang? Look okay?
Yeah.
All right. Okay,
Hey, Chuck, could you hold that together? Very good.
Use your glue-like fingers.
Man, be careful my artery. Yeah.
That'd be great.
Oh, sure, you let him stick a tattoo needle in you, but you're afraid of a little.
Well, cause there's a little difference between like a puncture wound and like, you know, slicing.
And dicing. Because then that means we'd have to bury you here. That's more work, Chuck.
In the floor of the wigwam.
Yeah, that'd be great.
I will become part of the wigwam.
That would be cool.
So moving on from that, we're moving on to another chase scene. This time it's with me, Ty Stick, and Trish. But we're being chased by this character. Fuck, I wish I could remember what its fucking name was. We gave this character a fucking name, but I can't remember what the fuck it was. But anyway, it's time for another chase scene. Oh hey, you get to watch my wife's tiggle bitties bouncing all over the fucking place here.
Thank you.
don't worry, you'll never have to see a continuation, because it never was continued. Ever. Ever. So anyway, moving on from that, we're moving on to more of Casey and Leanne's trip back across America, so check this out.
Side view of what we're seeing out this little window. It's nothing yet, but get to the top, we'll see St. Louis and Illinois.
Check it out, guys. It's a memorial we were looking at before. Here's the stadium. This is St. Louis. Now I'm gonna go back on the other side and we'll check out Illinois.
Sun.
But before the birds start calling,
stay awake and get some.
Get some rest and some fun done.
Measure time of season.
I don't have a clock or a calendar.
That might be the reason.
I live my life like I only got one.
Hey, Primal Soup. We're stuck in Ohio, Columbus, Ohio. It's snowing like hell in Pennsylvania. So, I'm gonna go for a little bike ride down to get a movie so we're not so bored. Take it easy and check out this clip.
Hi, Primal Soup. It's Leanne back again to say welcome back to Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania.
We made it home.
2,500 miles.
Good to be here safe.
So check out these clips, and it's great to be home.
2,300 miles.
So they finally made it home, and that ended the footage of Casey and Leanne's trip across America. So anyway, moving on from that, we're going to check back in on the wigwam and check out how that fucking shit's going.
In a little bit, and I may not use that. I don't know.
George played an Indian once. He did.
Yeah.
It wasn't Spirit of the Revolution.
Chunky Buffalo.
Chunky Buffalo.
Hey.
Chief White Buffalo.
Yeah.
Chief Great White Buffalo.
I'm the engineer on this project.
Now what do I do?
Hey, our wigwam's strong.
Wigwam. How strong is it? It's wigwam.
We're gonna do a segment. We're gonna strong. Do a short segment. Is how many times Ray fell off the ladder?
I like. I mean, Chuck, move that into position. Got that? Maybe not.
Chuck walks in like the Terminator. I will hold it.
I hold it.
I'll be back. Going to get more string.
Yes.
Now see, there's a plane gonna fly overhead, and they're gonna see this and think we're building like a bomb shelter. Or nuclear.
Site. Bomb shelters.
Bomb shelters. Now there's an idea that worked, huh? Millions of taxpayers' dollars to build bomb shelters that no one realized that you had to breathe the air. Duh. But that's okay. The government told us it was the thing.
Holy fucking Christ! Another GoVision.
In the same area, just wanted to kind of give you an idea how pretty this is with the rocks and the water. And of course, we ran into Doug and Dale again. And then it goes up through these pines, up to the road. David's testing the water to see how deep it is. He hasn't showered all week, so this is a good opportunity for him. Now he falls, we can put this on Funniest Home Videos. Clouds are just moving together, forming one big cloud. See the mountain peak to the right. Clouds on the left are moving into the cloud on the right.
So moving on from that, we're moving on to a skit that Tyler and I wrote. At this point, we were both very obsessed with Japanese horror, like the most fucked up Japanese horror you could fucking get. So this has its roots and its inspirations in like movies like Takashi Miike, stuff like Audition, Ichi the Killer, Visitor Q, but none of it's not that fucked up, obviously, because it had to be on TV, and this season we were ultra-censored. But anyway, here's our little take on Japanese horror. So it's been a while since we destroyed something. What, since that car, right? So I think it's about time we destroy something else. My original editing computer, the shittiest of shitty fucking computers, the one that I used fucking first, finally crapped out, and I wanted to destroy it. So, actually, I think it was Tyler's idea, but whatever, it doesn't fucking matter. Us beating the fuck out of a computer, that was fun fucking day.
Hey everybody, welcome to this new segment. Here with Ty, Strick, and Casey. And we have a little problem with technology. You might or might not know that all your money isn't real. It's all ones and zeros in that box. So we're going to have a little statement with Mr. Axe and Mr. Slade. So follow along.
Technology sucks.
Well, we got our computer set up. We decided who gets what. So here we go. I got a bottle. Technology is getting out of hand. Haven't any of you people ever seen The Matrix? I mean, for real!
Ones and zeros roar a lot.
What we think of your technology.
Worthless.
Crap. Takes jobs. Destroys everybody's lives. Comes the fun part of cleaning this all up.
See you, Chuck.
Yep. See you, Tyler.
Call India.
God, if technology was getting out of hand back then, what would past me say now? Oh yeah, fucking streaming stuff and YouTube and all this stuff's pretty fucking awesome. Yeah, it has its downsides, but I'm pretty happy with where technology's at now. So anyway, moving on from that, we're gonna check in on the fucking wigwam again.
And actually, now what you do to separate these, I'll come in and I'll put four circles around here of branches and tie them into this to make, you know, to give me my form. I just need
branches this size.
Yes, they're a little bit smaller.
It's America. We're free to build wigwams any time we want.
It's the only thing we're allowed to do anymore. Where are we going, Ray?
We're gonna follow us to Hickory. Actually, I have an ice here that may do well. Let's just go with this piece of ash. What do you think?
I think so.
A good piece of ash is sometimes better than hickory. Hickory's harder and more flexible. Well, I won't say it's harder because I actually make baseball. The Indians prayed for a saw like this, and I got it. Okay,
that's good. Look good?
All right, back to the wigwam.
All right.
Yeah.
Shave a little off of this. Traditionally we cover these with bark. That's how we used to do it.
We don't have enough bark.
Well, actually we do, but modern time we don't debark the tree.
So you know, every once in a while when you're doing stuff like this and you really have no plan on any of the stuff you're filming or anything like that, you know, you end up doing some stuff that you can't believe you ended up doing, and no, it's not sucking dick or anything like that. It is going to film a dude training for a strongman competition? Yeah, me and Casey fucking did that.
Hey Casey, look at this gray crappy Saturday.
Yeah, it is pretty gray and crappy.
So what are we doing? We're going up to see dude, right?
Yeah, we're gonna go see James Smith. He's a strongman competitor.
And today, since it's so rainy, he can't do any feats of strength for us, so he's going to show us his equipment that he built and made to practice for said strongman.
That's correct. Because if he would use that strongman equipment, he'd sink into the ground because his area is nothing but swamp today.
So anyway, we're going to check this stuff out today, and in the future, we're going to see him training and possibly even go into a competition. So, James Smith, Primal Soup's resident strongman.
Check it out. Hey, Primal Soup, Casey here, and I'm here with James Smith. How you doing, James?
Good.
He's training for a strongman competition, and he's going to explain to us some of the equipment that he uses when he does so. Go ahead, James.
All right, this is just the stuff I have out here now. These are my Atlas stones. As you can see, this is my platform I put the stones up on. It's varying heights. First stone here is 180, 263, 297, 313, 339. This is 405, and then this is another 335. So it's close to my 339. The platforms go from 6 foot down in 6 inch intervals. And the idea is just take the stones, lightest one up on the highest platform, heaviest one up on the lowest platform. Moving on to my kegs, I have tons of beer kegs. I got the old style keg that has the bung. These are full of concrete. Can't change the weight. I got six of them. They're right around 400 pounds. These I can do all kinds of stuff. Pick them up, carry them, throw them in my trailer, pick them up, baby cradle them, go for distance, whatever I want to do. The new style keg right here, I got four. They're varying weights. I have a sc- screw in top, you can take back out. The heaviest one right now I think is 300 pounds. The first one starts at 160. We just do sprint work, 10 yards, 30 feet. Grab the first keg, 10 yards, throw it, sprint back until you're done as many times as you want. Laying in the grass here is a Hoosafell stone. I used to have three of these. This one goes about 350 pounds. The idea is I put it up on the stump, pick it up, carry it for either timed distance or just max distance. I'm gonna be making a few more you guys will see in the future. One will be up to around 550 pounds or so. It'll be a beast. Another keg here I use to drag if I don't have my sled up here at the time. Got my tires. This tire right here is around 600 pounds. Do all kind of stuff. I go inside this tire, I pick it up, carry it for distance. It's about 650. Got this tire right here. This is 890. This is 1100. This is 1600. This is the big boy right here. I can flip that probably five or six times. I'm not gonna be doing that today because it's so swampy out. But you guys will see this. This is pretty intense. Got some barnstone on the ground right here. I used to have another one I gave to a good buddy of mine. This right here goes around 410. I've put it up on my shoulder before once. A lot of failed attempts, one successful so far, but you guys will be seeing that in the future. I'll get it up there on both shoulders. This here's a stone I shoulder carry for distance, all kind of stuff, whatever I want to do. So I'll have some more stuff up here later, but that's it for now.
All right, James. Thanks a lot. Yep. We'll go down to your house and check out some more equipment.
Yeah. Yep. All right, this is my indoor facility. It's not real big, but it's the weight pit. That's what me and my buddies call it. As you can see, it's pretty tricked out. I got almost everything you need. Squat rack, heavy duty squat rack, boxed in. Got my own deadlift platform that I built. Pull forward, rubberized. You can see all the goodies I have laying around here. This is the puke bucket right here. It's an important feature if you're gonna get sick when you're squatting or something. Basically, you guys will see as I go through and my workouts and stuff, all the different equipment I have. I don't have time to explain it all now, but this is it. This is where all the indoor training happens unless I go to my buddy's place. And other than that, I train outside.
I don't even know how we hooked up with that guy. I'm trying to remember. I think maybe Casey worked with him somewhere, something like that. That was definitely Casey's fucking hookup. So moving on from that, we're moving on to another photography artist showcase, Jerry Posimic. To that ongoing series that is the Wigwam. Let's check in on the progress.
Hey, wasn't that artist cool with the spray paint?
Yeah.
That guy was incredible. You gotta wonder what that dude's thinking the whole time he's moving 1,000 miles an hour, huh?
Yeah.
All right.
Did that make it into an episode yet?
It did. Last poll.
20 minutes of Vegas stuff and three artist showcases.
So
last episode.
How'd it turn out? Like it? Different?
Yeah, it's entertaining.
It's entertaining. It's fabulous.
We went from one that was like a super statement episode.
Yeah, Jack, the one that meant absolutely nothing.
With the light hitting you, dude, you are so white. It's unreal, dude.
Yeah, man. I'm
look
at
with
you.
These green glasses on, you look
but look
white
at you.
As hell.
You're white as hell.
I know. I need a tan.
Basement.
Ghosts.
Okay.
Basement dwellers.
Hold that pole over there.
It'd be a good movie.
Dad says, hold my pole. Chuck snaps into action.
Yeah, he's used to doing it. He's grabbed my dad's pole a couple times. It's hard to resist all that succulent ham, huh?
What are you doing, Marlon?
Yeah, what are you doing, idiot?
Grabbing your pole.
Well, grab it right, you moron.
Yeah. I'm sure you're the proper.
You're fine, I guess. Position.
Take it on. I hope this don't break. Can you get a little more? I knew that was too much. Ah, boy.
Trees!
You just pierced a bunny in the heart.
Heavy fine. Oh, $10.
Okay, let's
$10?
Okay, here's a strange little skit me and Bird came up with, right? Remember, you know, Bird's girlfriend and all the, like, hate and all that stuff that we have discussed throughout these retrospectives? Well, we wrote a skit where she kills him? Well, both of us? And surprisingly, she was like, yeah, I'll film it. We should have been fucking scared she didn't actually kill us in real life, but it's weird that, like, I don't even know what the fuck we were thinking at. I can't believe she actually did it.
Oh, man, get up. We gotta go up and film now.
No.
Come on. Hey, I'll get it. Hello? Yeah, hold on.
Christ. What? Yeah, I'm gonna film. Yeah, I know. That's what I always do. I gotta go, okay? I'm not listening to this bullshit night.
Lovely fun, isn't it?
Isn't it now? That was the Emperor.
Girlfriends are great, aren't they?
Yep.
Anyway, we gotta go out and film anyway. We'll get this done. So come on.
Once again, and this is another show. Ground with Soup is going to be a great show today. We're going to see all kinds of
outside, that's why I'm paying.
fucking Christ, another Go Vision.
Another shot, same area. Just wanted to get this mountain with the snow on it. Just amazing. It's July 19th. And all that snow. I stopped along the road. Little trail down to the creek. It's real pretty in here. Walking on pine needles. Here's a shot of the going to the Sun Road. And here's a creek coming down. Water's about 3 feet deep, and as you can see, it's crystal clear. This is another example of the way the plate pushed up over the western plate. You can see the strata is moving at an angle instead of horizontally. It comes down at an angle. So this mountain actually pushed up over the other one.
So moving on from that, we're checking back in on the wigwam and its fucking progress.
So wait a minute. This is the end of the wigwam for today?
This is the end of the wigwam for today.
Yeah. So you made us walk the whole way up here to build a dome.
A frame of sticks. Yes, I did. stay tuned. We'll finish this. There will be sticks, four rows of sticks around the outside to spread them, honey. Then there's going to be, there'll be a bench built on the inside. I'll put Y-shaped sticks around post, and then we'll build a bed of sticks. And we should cover it with bark, but I don't think we're going to use probably dog hide.
Okay, so the finished product to be seen on Primal Soup Season 47.
Yes.
Season. You think
four?
Okay.
Do you think we'll be around for a season? I mean, not an IUP, but do you think Primal Soup will be around for a season 47?
Yes. I don't know.
Yes. We barely have any ideas anymore as it is. We're just like, oh, that's just sleep. That's just sleep.
Ray, we were like, Ray, the new Hunter S. Thompson, the smaller version.
So yeah, that was the end of the wigwam segments. As far as I know, it was never completed. At least we never done anything else with it. And that was that. This retrospective's ending, and I'm just going to put a group of outtakes from different episodes that I like and I think they're pretty funny. I'm just going to put them up in the corner, let the credits fucking roll, and I'll see you next time for season 5 retrospective.
Man, look at you, you lazy piece of dude. Trying to get you to put signs up, you're like, I don't wanna. Why don't you want to, man? You're supposed to do your job. Be part of Primal Soup.
I'm part, just not part of this right now.
Well, you have to help promote us. How's someone going to see us if you can't promote us?
I don't know. I'll do it eventually.
No, you won't.
Probably not. Senses are coming for you. Chuck is now freezing his off. Sitting out there. We're doing about 50 up the hill. And Chuck's back here.
I just so want to be like J-Lo.
That's almost porn right there.
Take me to the magic of the moment. No, I was gonna sing them when you were doing the dance.
We're at it again.
Of course.
Hey, George.
Ah.
Make sure if you like right on him. I'm gonna go as fast as you go, but try to go slower.
Ah. The senses are coming!
I do like George Bush. I do. I love him.
Thanks for the wonderful filming idea.
Yeah, no problem, man.
Behind the scenes.
You had fun, didn't you?
Oh, I had lots of fun. You know, you guys did too.
Right now too.
Hey, I did part of my cleanup. That's just not filmed right now.
Clean up in aisle 5.
There's no proof you did any cleanup.
You said Americans won't do this crappy work.
Hey, we're not even getting paid. Well, isn't that kind of like every day?
Pretty much so.
Usually bust though and still don't get paid. Make the money for the man.
Entry-level wage. Entry-level wage.
So, Boo, this is what, Propaganda Man 5?
Is this 5?
This is 5.
Wow.
Lunatic.
Didn't think it'd last this long, huh?
Nope.
I don't know, we was just hanging out one day, couldn't think of nothing to film, and I said, hey, dress me up, I'll go hold out some cool signs in the middle of Freeport.
Sorry, Pacalica. We're even worse now, we're getting...
mankind and...
We have to resort to more technology to pick up our crap. All embedded in there. Super Suckin' Chuck.
We're vacuuming the lawn!
It'll look so pretty when we're done. Casey's so disgruntled. He still wants to break. Primal Soup does.
We have a little problem. As us being Primal Soup and guinea pigs and whatnot, we never think of the consequences of what we do. So we just got to clean up all this stuff. Now all we have millions of pieces of broken computer. What the hell are we going to do with it?
We don't know where to put it.
No idea.
Why don't we glue it back together and create a sculpture?
I'll make another head. Another hole for your head. Hold on. See, you can breathe more.
I got like 3 holes.
Okay, is that good?
Yeah.
Hold on.
What are you doing?
So what's going on, Tyler? You're hitting on Boo's little cousin.
Little 17-year-old cousin.
Hey, no hitting on nothing.
So she wasn't hot at all.
Well, just wait.
She wasn't hot at all?
So you didn't check out her once?
Nah, dude.
So just wait. I'm just
wait, no, I can't say no. I didn't. No, I think she is hot. Too bad that she is 17.
Well, it's Star Wars Day still, and it is now 7:30, and the show still doesn't start till midnight. So, me and Ty here are gonna play some cards, because we're bored. War with our all-American 52 most wanted Iraqi freedom cards.
Nice.
Never saw this before. So, yeah, here we go.
Hey Casey, don't you think we should tell everybody to go to Blanket Hill Speedway and like...
Sunday! Blanket Hill Speedway! Launch!
Oh, hey!
Oh.
Mellow, man.
Sorry.
But anyway, everybody, you need to go see some races or whatever, go to Blanket Hill Speedway, man.